So you went no contact, and now you're about to have the conversation to address it. Here's what both sides need to know before the meeting and what to do during the meeting to make it a success. Often these estrangements involve grandkids when parenting decisions are not respected, when boundaries or limits are completely disregarded. People often feel, people meaning adult kids, often feel like they have no choice but to go no contact for a period of time. So today, let's imagine that you're in this position, and I'm going to address both parties because you each have to prepare differently to make this meeting a success. First, let's set the intention for the meeting. It's about reconnecting and just starting to rebuild trust and establish clear and healthy boundaries. It's not about placing blame, but it's about figuring out a way to move forward that respects everyone's needs. For the adult kids, it is crucial that you come to this meeting with an understanding that just as much as you believe you deserve an apology and you feel like you are right, your parents, they also believe they're in the right. They're probably just as confused and hurt by you. And if they're grandkids, I will bet you $1 million they believe they were doing everything right for them. They're probably thinking, we've raised kids successfully. I don't understand why this estrangement or no contact even happened. They're likely absolutely devastated and in a lot of pain. And I want to give you a heads up that pain usually manifests as anger. So if your parents come to the meeting angry, bitter, hostile, just remember at the core, they're hurting so profoundly. Again, everybody coming to the meeting is confused and hurt, and they believe they're the ones that deserve an apology. Parents, you need to understand that if your adult child and spouse went no contact, it wasn't done lightly. They reached a point where they felt like, we have no other choice but to pause and take a break from this relationship because it is so overwhelming, the stress is all-consuming, and this isn't healthy for our family. So as they're coming to this meeting, you have to realize they're coming knowing that they're going to re-enter what they would describe as a stressful relationship. So you might pick up on some apprehension. Maybe, you know, they might be standoffish, distant, and it's because they're like, how is this going to look different? And they're just questioning. They're not sure how this is going to look. They initiated no contact out of desperation because the communication had broken down so bad. I'm sure they tried a variety of ways to talk this out before they reached their breaking point. So the no contact was to protect their sanity, the health of their family. As hurt as you feel, understand your adult child and your in-law is hurting too. Before I let you in on a common mistake, which is blaming the in-law, I want to welcome any newbies to the channel. My name is Jessica Miller. I am a boundary enthusiast, and my mission is to help bridge the gap between generations so that we understand each other better, establish healthy boundaries to avoid estrangement in the first place. If that sounds interesting to you, make sure you hit that subscribe button and stick around. Okay, now parents, before the meeting, listen up. I want to talk about a very common mistake that parents make, which is blaming the in-law. It's natural to blame an external source outside of your family. It's easier to think the problem is outside of me. It's outside of my family. It's outside of my child, because then it has nothing to do with me. And it hurts less as well, thinking about it that way, because nobody wants to think their child could ever hurt them this way. However, if you walk into this meeting with animosity or resentment directed right towards your in-law like a laser, it's not going to go well. And if your in-law is not the one who caused this estrangement, and it's actually just your adult child, like they're saying, if you show any hostility towards that in-law, it will only upset your adult child. Like, they're going to say, see, you don't believe anything I'm saying. I am telling you, it is me making the decision and you're directing all the anger at her. It will just create more distance. But let's say the in-law is to blame. Let's say, you know, they're very manipulative. If they are, you don't think they've been planting seeds of doubt in your child's, in your adult child's brain this whole time? So if you show up bitter and hostile towards them, that will only confirm those doubts, and that's going to drive a wedge further between you and your adult child. So either way, listen to me. Blaming the in-law and coming in all hostile is a sure way to grow the divide between you and your child. It's a lose-lose situation. So get your mindset right. Don't blame the in-law. And just remember, your adult child isn't being forced into this. They made the choice to pull away which means there is something between you guys. There's something in the relationship that needs to be worked on. Approach this meeting with an open mind and an open heart, ready to listen and understand. So as you prepare for the meeting, I want you to think about what nuggets has your adult child or in-law given you prior to the estrangement or the break. Reflect on what they've said, how they've said your actions have made them feel. Maybe they've made them feel disrespected, overwhelmed. And I'm not saying you intentionally made them feel that way. I'm actually saying the opposite. I believe parents do their very best with what they have. Even though your intention was never to hurt them, it's important that you acknowledge their feelings. And you might feel like, I'm not apologizing for something I didn't do. I think we can all agree you never, ever, ever intentionally meant to hurt your adult child or your in-law, ever. So as long as we can agree on that, that's what you're apologizing for. I'm not directly saying, I'm sorry I did this. This was very bad. I'm not saying that. I'm saying, I am so sorry I made you feel disrespected. Like, as your mom, I would never want my child to feel disrespected. I'm really sorry. That's what I'm apologizing for. I'm apologizing that my actions made my child feel a certain way. I'm acknowledging that. And as long as you can get your mind around that, like, it's not about, like, get your ego out of the way. It's not about right or wrong. It's about, shoot, you're saying when I did X, I made you feel Y? Oh, I'm so sorry. I would never want you to feel Y. I'm really, really sorry that my X action made you feel that way. And once you acknowledge your adult child's feelings and your in-law's feelings, what you're saying is, I'm willing to make amends and I want to work towards a healthier relationship. Adult kids and in-laws, I know how it feels to be on this side of the equation. It is awful. The level of disrespect and hurt you had to get to take a break, it's a lot. And the amount of stress that led you to finally, like, oof, go no contact is now leading you to have, like, anxiety about even the thought of reengaging, because you feel like in order to have a relationship with these parents, we have to be, like, stressed out all the time. It's intimidating, it's overwhelming. Like I said, it's anxiety provoking. And you might not believe an apology is coming, but I wanna remind you that parents do the very best they can with the tools they were given. Some were not given a lot of tools. But I do know the majority of parents do not, would never, ever intentionally hurt their children, period. Which means they most likely did not mean to hurt you, and they're feeling just as misunderstood, unappreciated, and betrayed by this no contact. So if they're hostile, remember, they're hurting too. And if you have a hard time putting yourself in their shoes, just imagine one of your children going no contact with you. How incredibly painful would that be? So a little grace for this meeting will go a long way. During the meeting, adult kids, it would be so helpful if you started off by saying, I know you never meant to hurt us, but when you did X, it made us feel Y. This approach will acknowledge their intentions while expressing your feelings. Parents, this is your cue. You're up. Now it's time to validate your child's feelings. And you can say, you're right. We never, ever intended on hurting you. We are so sorry that when we did X, it made you feel why. We really want to learn how to avoid this in the future. Now this opens up the dialogue, right? Now we are going to talk about, what do healthy boundaries look like? And you're going to work together to figure out how to honor what your adult child and your in-law needs. Adult kids and in-laws, before you go to the boundary setting stage, you also need to return the favor to your parents. You have to acknowledge their feelings now. Say something like, thank you so much for acknowledging our feelings and our pain. We can only imagine how painful and confusing this time period has been for you. We're also sorry that it came to this, and we want to set healthy boundaries moving forward. So when both sides acknowledge each other's pain, it helps heal the relationship. Now you can move on to discussing healthy boundaries, what they look like, what you're going to do to hold your boundary, what you're going to do, like, in terms of a behavioral change if they're not able to respect or honor your boundary, your limit. And parents, this is when you want to ask all the clarifying questions. You do not want to leave this meeting without clarity. One last very, 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 very important thing to note. If there are grandkids involved, parents, do not bring up the grandkids first. Do not. Wait until your adult child and your in-law bring it up to you and then follow their lead. Go slow, take your time. When you wait for them, you're showing like our relationship, your needs, your feelings matter so much to us, and having access to our grandbabies, that's second. So we are here to fix our relationship with the parents of the grandkids, so with our adult children and the in-law. We are not focused on gaining access to our grandkids. Trust me, you could do everything right in this meeting, and the moment you bring up the grandbabies before your adult child or your in-law does, it just makes it seem like they don't matter, and in your whole motive of having the meeting was just to get to the grandkids. And I know that that's not true. I know that you can want to have access to your adult child and your grandkids at the same time, but trust me, it does not come off great. Finally, remember, if there is tension with your in-law and you know that they're being manipulative and trying to pull your adult child away, showing up hostile towards them is only going to affirm all the seeds they're planting in your adult child's brain. But if you show up just like you always are, just kind, calm, respectful, loving, that's gonna create this cognitive dissonance in your child's like body, thinking, wait a minute, Stephanie always says my mom is such a bee to her, but when my mom shows up, she's always so kind to Stephanie, like what's going on? And eventually he'll start to see, or she'll start to see, the in-laws' true colors on their own. Like, give your adult child the benefit of the doubt. Do not think you need to be the one to prove the case that the in-law is rotten. Show up consistently as your kind, loving self and allow your adult child to see it for themselves. I know this was a quick one, but I really wanted to lay out the point of the meeting, how to like prep for the meeting, what to do inside the meeting. And again, you're showing up to the meeting to feel seen and understood. You're apologizing, taking accountability, and you're not bringing up the grandkids. And then you're able to open the line of communication to talk about what healthy boundaries look like, and you're asking questions, clarifying questions to make sure everyone's on the same page before the meeting ends. A no contact arrangement is the last resort. So now that you're in the meeting and you're discussing ways to move forward and heal, let's just stay true to the path, be very open, willing to change, open mind, open heart, so that this doesn't happen again. Please, please, please do not bring up the grandkids before your adult child does, and then just follow their lead. Remember, reconnecting after a time period of estrangement or going no contact, it's tough. It's very, like, you're gonna be apprehensive, you're gonna be nervous, you're still just kind of like scarred. So have empathy. Be patient and have clear communication. With empathy, patience, clear communication, it's definitely possible to rebuild trust and strengthen your relationship. Thank you so much for being here today. If you've learned something, hit the like button. If you learned two things, please share it with somebody that you know needs to hear this message. And until next time, friend, make sure you keep minding your boundaries.